Hey, thanks so much for joining me today. My name is Jerry and I am one frugal introvert. I discuss budgeting, cash stuffing, and everything regarding personal finances. So if you are interested in this type of content, then please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Also remember to hit that notification bell so that you're always aware of when I post new content. So I am a digital and cash sinking fund stuffer. I started a couple of digital sinking funds a few years ago before I even knew what that term meant. And once I did learn what it meant, I just kind of went sinking funds crazy. So today I'm gonna stuff my digital sinking funds, which is in this yellow binder here, with prop money for the very first time. So everything that I'm going to be using in this video, I will leave a link to it in the description box below. So I do have my prop money here, which I did get from Amazon, but the 5K and the 1K slips I got from Big Money Teens on Etsy. So I'll leave her link down in the description box below. So what I'm gonna do is count the money and then put it in my cash tray. So if you're interested in seeing me stuff my digital sinking funds, then just keep watching. So I'm gonna move these two binders and I'm going to count my money. So y'all are gonna have to watch me struggle counting this money because I have found that this prop money is really hard, at least for me, to separate. So please bear with me. So I'm gonna be stuffing a total of $15,625. So 5, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14,000. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 15,000. 1, 150, 2, 253, 350, 400, 20, 40, 60, 80, 500, 20, 40, 60, 70, 80, 90, 600, 5, 10, 15, 20, 22, 24 and 25. So that is $15,625. So I'm gonna go ahead and lay my money out and then I'll be right back. All right, so I am back. I've laid my money out. And here is my binder that I'm gonna be using. This is my cheat sheet that I'll be referring to with all of my totals written on here. And without further ado, let's get to stuffing. So for my tech envelope, I have $210 in it. So 100, 200, and $210. Next is my medical expenses. I have $65 in it. So 50, 60, and $65. Next is property taxes, which I will be depleting soon. Because my vehicle taxes are actually due in July, but I currently have $190 in it and it is fully stuffed. So 100, 150, 170.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
What am I doing? 100, 150, 170. And 190. Next is my emergency fund, which is fully funded. So I'm gonna take my 1K slip here and put it in this envelope. And by the way, I don't think I mentioned this, but all of my digital sinking funds are in a high yield savings account in my Ally bank account. So next is vacations, which is real slim right now. I only have $70 in it, but it's all right. I'll keep stuffing it until I get to where I wanna be. I don't have a particular amount that I wanna save as of yet, but I'm just gonna keep stuffing it. So $50 and $70. Next is my 3 to 6 months worth of expenses, which I'll actually do a separate video on that, on how I went about determining how much money I actually needed to stuff in this envelope. So please be sure to stick around so that you can see that video. But I currently have $1,550 in this particular envelope. I also want to, at some point, probably get some $500 placeholders. So I'm probably gonna get that, and then I'll do like a bill exchange video in the future. But right now I'm gonna just work with what I have. So I'm gonna take another 1K slip here, 1,000, and then 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, and 50. So yeah, I wanna get the $500 placeholder so that I can just replace these $100 bills and condense my sinking funds, but we're not worried about that as of yet. So I've got $1,550 in here. Shots fired, this envelope, I am saving up for a gun. I only have $38 in it so far. 20, 30, 35, 37, and 38. Next is new whip. I am saving up to purchase a new whip. I don't need one right now, but it doesn't hurt to start saving up for one. So I currently have $75 in it. So 50, 70, and $75. Next is home. This is the very first digital sinking funds that I started when I was living at home with my grandmother, and I was able to contribute a lot of money towards it. I didn't have a lot of bills to pay, so I was like, well, this is the perfect opportunity for me to start saving up for a down payment on a home. So even though I don't plan on purchasing a home anytime soon, I am still contributing money in this envelope regularly, just so that I can be prepared for when I actually am ready to purchase a home. So in home, I have $12,145 in it. So I think I'm going to maybe cap this at $15,000. We'll see. I'm not too sure yet, but I think I want to cap it at $15,000. So I'm going to take my 5K slips. Oops. So 5,000, 10,000, 11,000, 12,000 here. And then 100, 20, 40, and 45. So $12,145. Lastly is my Bluehost envelope. So I am actually working on a blog called One Frugal Introvert. It is not live yet, but I'm still working on it. Bluehost is the actually what hosts my blog. So I pay annually for that. I think it's due like October, late October, early November-ish. I gotta double check on that. But this is fully funded right now, so I have $282 in there. So I think I have the correct amount. Yeah, 100, 200, 250, 270, 280, and 282.
Hey Hey guys, so I actually wanted to stop the video right here because I just realized that I paid for Bluehost like 3 years in advance. So I actually don't need that money as of right now. So what I'm going to end up doing is I'm going to take the money out of that Bluehost sinking fund and I'm going to put it towards one of my debts probably. I'm not quite sure yet, but I'll figure that out. But just stay tuned for that. So back to the video.
All right, so those were all of my digital sinking funds. And then in future videos, you will see me stuff my cash sinking funds. So basically with the digital sinking funds, with those, I have those in a high yield savings account, which is Ally Bank, which I mentioned earlier. So the way that I determine which ones are gonna be digital and which ones are gonna be cash, the ones that are digital are going to have the most money in them and the ones that I'm going to touch less frequently. The cash ones are the ones that I am going to probably touch more often and are not going to have as much cash in them because I don't want to keep that much cash in my home. So as you can see here, I got like Christmas gifts, which don't mind that. I've spent a lot of money in that. Car maintenance, glasses, which I've actually depleted because I got a new pair of glasses, clothes, Amazon Prime, and a bunch of other ones that I haven't stuffed as of yet. But that's kind of how I figure out which ones are going to be digital and then which ones are going to be cash. But I just thank you for stopping by. So if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. And once again, don't forget to hit that notification bell so that you're always aware of when I post a new video. So with that being said, peace out.